Hi friends, many students, especially the students from non-English medium background schools, they face problem. They say that they feel tense because they cannot understand the tenses. They say that they cannot understand the grammar. In fact, any language which is prevalent all over the world, especially the English or any other language, for example, vernacular languages, Hindi or Punjabi or any other language, they are surviving just because the grammar is easier in those languages. So grammar, when easy, can be understood well if systematically learned. So we'll be talking something about the tense and then sentence. I am Dr. Harpreet Singh, Principal, Gujranwala Guru Nanak Institute of Management and Technology, Ludhiana in Punjab. So we'll be learning the basics of tenses today. Before that, just see what I'm speaking. The pen, the hen, the university, the elephant, the fox. I repeat, the pen, the hen, the university, the elephant, the fox. So here what I'm doing is, if you have listened carefully, I spoke the. So why I spoke the before elephant? Because elephant, E, that is the vowel sound. So wherever vowel sound is there, we go for the. And all other consonant sounds, then the pronunciation is the. So what does mean is, if we listen carefully, grammar can be understood well. So listening is very important. So in the next slide, I'll be talking about the various tenses. Please listen carefully. So there are three categories: present, past, and future. And in that, indefinite, perfect, continuous, and perfect continuous. So we'll take present indefinite first. Let me clarify here. Present means the present point of time. We are talking about present point of time. I'm referring to point of time. I'm not talking about period of time. Please understand, for tenses, important thing is point of time. So when we are talking about present, means we are talking about the point of time right now. Past means point of time which was before the present point of time. Future means present point of time is there, but the future point, a point of time after the present point of time. Right? So present point of time, past point of time, future point of time. Indefinite means when we are not definite, when we are not pakka, when we are not sure which point of time we are referring to. Right? So that is indefinite. So present indefinite means I play hockey. I play hockey means that main hockey khelta hoon, main hockey khelda haan. If I say when, it's very indefinite. Nobody knows definitely when. Right? So we are not clear which point of time we are referring to. So I say I play hockey. It's indefinite. It's not very clear. It's not very sure what we are talking about. So similarly, past, I played hockey. Main hockey khela. Kab? When? I am not clear. Right? So past, point of time is past, means it is not the present one, but it's not very definitely known when. Before the present time, when in the past. So when it is not clear, it is indefinite. I shall play hockey. Main hockey khelunga. Kab? Subah, sham ko, morning, evening, tomorrow, a day after tomorrow, when I'll be growing older, or when. We are not sure. So it is not sure. It's not definite. So we call it indefinite. So the point of time is after the point of the present point of time. So it is the future, but it's not very definite. So indefinite part is present indefinite, past indefinite, future indefinite. In writing, the rule is very simple. In the Present indefinite, we always use the first form of the verb. So the sentence is subject, first form of the verb, and the object. The only rule in the present indefinite is whether to place S or ES. So if it's a singular object, we place S or ES with the first form of the verb. Otherwise, we don't do it. Right? So I is the subject, play is the first form of the verb play, and the hockey, that is the object. So I play hockey. Similarly, in the past is the second form of the verb. That's the only rule. Same subject, second form of the verb, and the object. So I played hockey. When? I can't say. So it is indefinite. So I play hockey. I played hockey. In future, the rule is to use shall or will as the auxiliary verb, the helping verb. So we use shall or we use will, and with shall and will, always the first form. With shall and will, always the first form. There is no other rule. So with I and we use shall. With all other subjects except I and we use will. But there is one another rule here. If I do use I and we, right, and I'm using, instead of shall, I'm using will. So I say I will play hockey, we will play hockey. So if I am changing shall with will with I and we, and will with shall with all other subjects, then it means I'm pakka saying मैं तो हॉकी खेलूंगा, means I will play hockey, कि मैं पक्का हॉकी खेलूंगा, definitely I'll play hockey. When point of time is not definite, but I'm confirming I'll play hockey. So we reverse shall and will if we want to confirm, if we want to reinforce what we are saying. So rule here is I play hockey. So to reconfirm, we say I do play hockey. I played hockey. To confirm, reconfirm, we say I did play hockey. Now did is the second form. So with the main verb play, again second form will not be used. So I did play hockey. So I play hockey, I played hockey, I shall play hockey. Simple indefinite rule is clear now. I shall play, I played hockey, I played hockey, I shall play hockey. Similar in perfectly we know that we are talking about a point of time perfectly with respect to the point of time now we have, the present point of time. I have played hockey means perfectly I know when I played hockey, it was a time definitely before the present point of time. So what does it mean? I have played hockey. Main hockey khel chuka hoon. Who means I am talking about the present point of time. So I have played hockey. So with all plural subjects and I, we use have plus third form of the verb. With all other subjects, singular subjects, we are using has. So he has played hockey, she has played hockey, they have played hockey, I have played hockey. So with singular objects, singular subjects we are using has. With I and all other plural subjects we are using have. And the rule is wherever has and have is there, the only rule in English is the third form of the verb. Main verb, third form. So I have is there. So third form, played hockey, the object. So I have played hockey. Similarly in the past, the second form of the auxiliary verb have is have had, has had. So in past we use second form. So we have used had instead of have or has, we have used had. Now because had is there, only rule is with has, have, had, the third form of the main verb will be there. So we use here, I had played hockey. Similarly in future, the thumb rule is if future, then shall has to come. So I shall is there. Now the rule is that it has to be shall with always the first form. First form is has, have, had. The first form is the have. So I shall have. So rule is justified that with shall we have gone for the first form of the verb have. With have, main verb always in the third form. So played. So I shall have played hockey. So with will and shall, first form, rule is there. So has or have, first form. So have is the first form. With have, always the third form in the main verb. So play, played, played. So third form of the verb. Object is hockey. So I shall have played hockey. So the again rule is, I have played hockey, I had played hockey, I shall have played hockey. Clear? So half of the tenses are over. Now coming to the continuous. Continuous means with the present of part of time, we know that it's still on. It's carrying on. Right? So where we know that it is going on, right? So if we say it is going on right now with the present point of time, so it becomes the present continuous. Right? Similarly, if it was running, it was going on, but at the not at the present point of time, it was referred to some point of time before the present point of time. So we say it was the past continuous, or we say it will be going, means we are talking about the point of time when it will be after the present point of time, but it will be consistently going, something we are talking about. So it will be future continuous. So I play hockey, that was the main sentence in the present indefinite. So in continuous is always ing word is used, ing suffix is used with the first form of the verb. So I is the subject, play, ing, playing, that is always the verb, but with subject always the first form has to be used. So we insert am there. Am means be, was, been. Be is the first form, which is also referred to as am for I. Right? Is for all other subjects. For I, it is am. For all other subjects, it is. So I am, first form, am, done. So then the main verb, first form with ing, playing hockey. So I am playing hockey. If I use the subject other than I, then it will be he is playing hockey. So is the first form. Be is referred as am or is or are. If the plural subject is they are playing hockey. So remember please, am, is and are referring to be as the first form of the verb. B-E-B. Be, was, been. So if the subject is I, then am. If the subject is singular, then is. If the subject is plural, then are. So I am playing hockey. He is playing hockey. They are playing hockey. Clear? So with the first form of the main verb, always to use ing. But to satisfy the rule that in the present, the first form of the verb has to be used. So we use it in the helping verb, the auxiliary verb. Am is the first form. Similarly, in the past, be, was, been. So was with the singular subjects, were with the plural subjects. So I was playing hockey. I was playing hockey. They were playing hockey. She was playing hockey. Mohan is playing hockey. So with wherever Mohan is playing hockey, it is the present one. Right, Mohan was playing hockey, it is the past continuous. So similarly, in the future, with the subject, we'll have to use shall or will. So shall use I shall, we shall, she will, he will. But the rule is, with shall or will, always to use first form of the verb. In the main form, because it is continuous, so ing has to be used, so playing. So the rule will not be done here, that with shall or will, we are using the first form of the verb, but ing is there. So to complete that rule, that with the shall or will, only the first form can be used. So we are inserting be there. Be, was, been. Be is the first form. So I shall be playing hockey. So B is representing the first form, which is a thumb rule, which is the confirmed rule that with will and shall only the first form can be used. That is why we inserted B here. So I shall be playing hockey. He will be playing hockey. They will be playing hockey. We shall be playing hockey. So rule is justified. With will and shall, we are using the first form in the form of be. And for continuous, we are using ing with the main verb. So playing. So I shall be playing hockey. Now 75% of the tenses are over. Now we are coming back to the present perfect continuous. So perfectly we know when it was continuous. With respect to the present point of time. So I have been playing. You see, perfect, so have has to be used. Continuous, ing has to be used. But with have, third form has to be used. So we inserted been there. Be was been. Been is the third form. So with have, we have used the third form. I have been. Continuous, first form, main verb, ing. So playing, that rule is also justified. Perfect, has or have has to be used, so that is also justified. With the third form, only has and have in the, so that is used in the helping verb. So I have been playing hockey. Then in present perfect continuous, for or since is used, as we always know. Whenever we can count on the time, we say it is for. When we cannot count on the fingers the time period, we say it is since. So I have been playing hockey for 2 hours. For 2 hours, we could count two on fingers, so we say for. Otherwise, I have been playing hockey since morning. So since morning, I cannot count because I don't know right now what is the point of time and since morning from when. So we cannot count it, so we use it since. So I have been playing hockey for 2 hours. I have been playing hockey since morning. Similarly, in the past, the second form is of the have or has is had, so we'll use had. Third form is been, for continuous ing, so we are using I had been playing hockey for 2 hours. The same rule there as well. Similarly, in the future, will or shall has to be used. With will or shall, the first form have, with the first form have has been used, and with have, third form has to be used, so been is there, and then for continuous, ing is there, so I am playing is there. So I shall have been playing hockey for 2 hours. So I repeat, I play hockey, I played hockey, I shall play hockey, I have played hockey, I had played hockey, I shall have played hockey, I am playing hockey, I shall be playing, I was playing hockey, I shall be playing hockey, I have been, I had been, I shall have been playing hockey for 2 hours. So the tenses are over here, please. Thank you very much.